Ce ați știut despre România înainte să veniți în țara noastră și ce impresie v-a făcut primul contact cu România?
Well, I didn't know much about Romania. I had been here a few times before I came, but coming here is completely different. It's a wonderful country. It's a great town, Bucharest. A lot of nice people, a lot of nice food, good wine. So you have to actually be careful here.
În 1989, în aceste zile de decembrie, românii au ieșit în stradă ca să înlăture comunismul și să intre pe calea democrației. Într-un interviu anterior v-ați exprimat foarte plastic că am încercat să parcurgem drumul de la Rățușca cea urâtă la Lebăda cea frumoasă. Nouă ni se pare că am rătăcit drumul ăsta. Dumneavoastră cum ne găsiți?
Well, I think that the Romanian people have come quite far. I mean, when you look at what Romania was in the situation Romania was in 1989, it was actually difficult in many ways, more difficult than other Eastern European countries, because I lived in that time, or soon after, in the Czechoslovakia, and Czechoslovakia had a very strong dissident movement. It was not really the case here in Romania. And still, Romania has come quite far. You have democratic institutions, you have functioning democracy here, and I think the structures are good. And the people need to have more confidence in these structures, to actually believe in them and to vote at the elections and to give the politicians a strong mandate.
Suntem împreună în UE și în NATO, dar puterea de la București începe să aibă un tot mai pronunțat discurs anti-european și a ajuns chiar să considere reprezentanții Bruxellesului și alte țări europene ca fiind dușmani ai Bucureștiului. Cum priviți lucrurile astea?
Well, I think first of all you have to realize that Brussels can never be your enemy. When you join the European Union, you join a club that has rules and has values. The role of the institutions in Brussels are to observe these rules. It's like a referee in a football match. And when you join a football tournament, like Romania wants to play in the European football tournament, you cannot make the rules that say that the offside rule is not counting in Romania. You have to play by the same rules. And that's what the institutions are doing. They're making sure that we're all playing by the same rules. The justice and legal system has to be independent. We cannot have political control of the legal system. This is the conflict that we have with other members of the European Union, unfortunately, right now. This was something we would hope that we wouldn't also have to have with Romania. But it's not being done to be an enemy of Romania, certainly not of the Romanian people. It may be the enemy of a few people who would like to benefit from changing the rules, but it's certainly not an enemy of the Romanian people.
De 2 ani de zile, puterea de la București este concentrată pe legile justiției, urmărind obsedant amnistia și grațierea, chiar și a faptelor de corupție. Cum ar suna amnistierea faptelor de corupție în Danemarca?
Well, I think it would never be the case in Denmark. I have said also earlier that I think that we have laws in Denmark, but really the Danish politicians are sometimes even more afraid of the media than the prosecutors when it comes to corruption. Any little hint of misuse of office is basically like saying goodbye to your political career in a country like Denmark. And this is maybe one of the differences that I notice here, is that I'm surprised with the stories you have that the media is not more active in pursuing some of the stories when it comes to corruption among leading politicians.
În fragila noastră democrație, de cele mai multe ori, opoziția a fost făcută de către ambasadele țărilor occidentale și reprezentanții Bruxellesului. În ultima perioadă, însă, societatea civilă și cei care protestează simt că acest semnal dinspre ambasade, dinspre Bruxelles, este tot mai slab. Se simt cumva părăsiți. Credeți că problema Marii Britanii e atât de importantă încât noi am fost abandonați?
Well, it's true that Europe has been busy with a lot of other things. Brexit is a big issue, of course, but there's also the situation in Ukraine, the situation with Russia, and the general geopolitical picture with competition from China, the new developments in the United States, etc. So there are a lot of things on the European agenda that we need to address, which is also why it's an unwelcome, unnecessary distraction that we actually, if we have to end up using European time also dealing with an issue like things related to the rule of law here in Romania. Romania is taking over the European Union presidency at a time where it's very important that we are strong Europeans, that the Europeans stand together, that we deal with the challenges we face after Brexit and so on. we shouldn't have to spend time also debating whether, you know, issues in Romania become a problem for the rest of the European Union.
Schimburile comerciale dintre România și Danemarca nu sunt la un nivel foarte ridicat. În condițiile în care legislația fiscală în România se schimbă de pe o zi pe alta, taxarea se schimbă, mai au firmele daneze încredere să investească în România?
Well, actually there are a lot of Danish companies in Romania. I think we know of around 600 Danish companies who have activities here. We know of around 10,000 jobs that have been created in Romania by Danish companies. So there is actually a great interest for Romania among Danish companies, among some of the larger Danish companies also investing here. One of the big insulation companies who makes things that make our buildings more efficient with the energy, Rockwool, is building a new big factory in Ploiești, creating a lot of jobs. So I think there is an interest. But of course, a stable environment, a stable fiscal environment, but also a stable political environment is important for attracting more. I see it as my ambition to get more Danish companies to come to Romania.
Ați fost diplomat în Statele Unite, în mandatul președintelui Obama. Trăim în era Trump acum, nicio zi fără președintele Trump în media. Societatea americană pare tot mai divizată, poate la fel cum e și societatea românească. Cum percepeți mandatul lui Trump?
Well, I think that the I don't know if we can speak about a Trump era. I think that a lot of things are happening not only in the United States but also in Europe, with people asking questions about the countries they live in, the democracies they live in. I think we live in a globalized world where many things become difficult to change, because if we change something only in Europe, it's going to be difficult, because then, you know, it will affect our ability to compete with the Chinese, let's say, and other people. So for normal people, they see, well, we get less and less influence on our life. And then it's easy, unfortunately, it's easy for some people to tell them stories that are very simplistic about how they will change everything if you give them the power. We see that, I think, unfortunately, with Brexit. We see that in America, maybe with some of the developments there. And we may see it again also in Europe. We're having European elections for the parliament in May. So I think we need to keep an eye. If politicians tell you something that's too good to be true, it is too good to be true.
Tot mai mulți europeni cred că Donald Trump dorește dezbinarea Uniunii Europene. Dezbină și stăpânește, pe când o altă parte îl văd pe Donald Trump ca un apostol, un mesia al libertății. Cum vedeți evoluția relațiilor UE-Statele Unite?
Well, the European-American relationship remains very strong. It's historical, it's based on our common security, but it's based on something much more important, it's based on common values. And this will not change with one president or even one European leader or one European country. This is something very fundamental, and I think this will remain. And there may be a lot of talk and there may be a lot of rhetoric, but when we look at the realities, the cooperation between the European Union, between Europe and America in NATO as well, is strong and remains strong.
Cum se vede în Danemarca Brexitul? Cât de slăbită e Uniunea Europeană fără Marea Britanie?
Well, I think in Denmark we see Brexit as very unfortunate. We entered the European Union in 1972 with the UK and Ireland. And it's very strange that they are now decided to leave the European Union. For Denmark, the British have always been a very strong ally in the European Union. We have very many views we look at the same way, liberal approaches to trade, etc. So we're very sad that the British are leaving. I think also the fact that they're leaving has changed maybe the minds of some Danes who are skeptical about the European Union, because they can see it's not so easy. I mean, look at the unfortunate things that are happening right now in London. It's very difficult to see that anybody really knows what to do about Brexit. So for many, some of the Danes who were skeptical about the European Union, who maybe even wanted a Dexit or a Danish exit, have been sort of having second thoughts, thinking, maybe this is not such a good idea. Whether Europe can you know, manage without Britain? Yes, of course we can manage without Britain. First of all, because Britain will not slide away, you know, it's the island will not sail away from Europe, it will still be there. We will still work with the British on a number of issues, everything from security, which is very important, to foreign policy and even to trade issues, we'll still be working with the British. So I'm not seeing the British leaving us completely. But for political reasons, they will need a different relationship to the European institutions. But the other good news is that Europe has not fallen apart. Some people in among the Brexiteers in Britain were hoping, I think, that the European Union would fall apart, that Britain leaving the European Union would be the European Union disintegrating. And that hasn't happened, and that, I think, is a very positive development.
Vin alegerile europarlamentare și mai probabil migrația va fi tema principală. Cum credeți că se vor desfășura ele?
Well, I think migration is on a lot of people's minds, and for good reason. It's been mentioned a lot in the media. There has been, as we know, in 2015-16, a lot of people coming to Europe. Right now, there are not very many people coming to Europe. But it showed how sensitive the whole issue is, and it showed maybe that our structures, our common European structures, were not strong enough to deal with these issues. And I think we need to realize that. But instead of criticizing the structures for not working, we should say, okay, how do we make them work? And I think that's important when we also think about the European Union or the European Parliament elections, that we think, well, let's vote for the people who have solutions. Let's not vote for the people who just tell us that everything is bad. Let's vote for the people who actually can tell us what should we then do.
Ați vorbit despre fenomenul fake news într-un interviu anterior. Care credeți că e direcția pe care ar trebui să se miște Uniunea Europeană privind fake news, fenomenul fake news?
Well, fake news is a very difficult subject because what is fake news? I mean, if I tell you a story now and you put it online and it turns out to be wrong, is it then fake news? Are you deliberately making fake news? Am I deliberately? Or do we just have a different opinion? It's difficult. There are clearly structural, I would call it kind of structural fake news, in the sense that it's being used as a strategic tool by certain countries, even certain powers, to influence politics in other parts of the world. This is what we saw in the American election. I think we saw it in Brexit as well. That kind of fake news is one thing, but you have a whole phenomenon of social media, which I think we have to get used to, that the debate is different. It's not a debate where two people are just sitting across from each other. It's a debate with a lot of people talking together at the same time, and pieces of information flying through the air which you can never verify in the same way as you can in traditional media.